Praise God, praise God. Ain't God good today? I realize that I've not been on Facebook for the past week and a half, 2 weeks, something like that. You know, sometimes we have to get away and really pray and talk to the Lord. Seek His guidance, seek His directions. I am looking forward to holding the revival up by Anderson, Missouri, over at the Holiness Church there at Cedar Grove, and looking forward to it, Brother Buddy. I feel like that the Lord's going to move in a mighty way. You're asking me why? Because I expect something from God. That's why. People might say, well, there's no real or truth in this, but it is. Let me tell you, each and every one of us has got a battle to fight. And this is what I like to preach on today, is that many battles to be fought, but the war is already won. And I thought, you know, we've got battles to fight each and every day. Glory be to God. If you would, go with me to 2 Samuel chapter 23. I want you to notice it says, these be the names of the mighty men whom David had. And I can pull out many topics to preach on out of these verses. But listen, the Tachamite that sat in the seat, chief among the captains, the same was Adoniah the Ezonite. He lifted up his spear against 800 whom he slew at one time. And after him was Eleazar the son of Dodo the Ahohite, one of the three men with David when they defiled the Philistines that were gathered together to battle. And the men of Israel were gone away. He arose and smote the Philistines until his hand was weary, and his hand clave unto the sword. And the Lord brought a great victory that day. And the people returned after him only to spoil. Amen. You can go on down in this chapter, and it talks about more men that had fought for David. Glory be to God in the battles. Let me tell you, we got battles to fight each and every day. Well, what battle are you talking about? It's a spiritual battle, amen. And we got to make sure that we've got the whole armor of God on. It seems like a lot of people think that they can just fly by and do nothing. Glory be to God. But let me tell you, we got a battle to fight. It's a battle of the mind. It's a spiritual battle. Glory be to God, and we must arm ourselves. Well, how do we arm ourselves? By putting on the whole armor of God on. Glory be to God. My, let me tell you something. We've got battles to fight each and every day. Your battle may not be my battle. Your temptation may not be my temptation. We've each and every one got our own battles to fight each and every day. That's the reason why that it's so important that we pray. That's the reason why it's so important that we need to go to church. Amen. We go to church not to look at people. We don't go to church to look at this one or that one. But we go to church to get help from God. We go to church to worship God. Amen. Glory be to God. If there's a time that we need to get our eyes upon Jesus Christ, is today. Amen. Glory be to God. Let's get our eyes off of this one and off of that one. But let's get our eyes set on the goal ahead of us. We got battles to fight, church. And the only way that we can fight this battle is prayer, fasting, calling out to God. We got battles to fight, church. Glory be to God. And the only way that we can do it is to use it by the name of Jesus. Yes, I said by the name of Jesus. Glory be to God. Well, why is that? I'm fixing to tell you why. Because, glory be to God, I want you to notice, my glory be to God, in the book of Luke chapter 23 and 46 as they crucified him. And when Jesus had cried with a loud voice, he said, Father, into thy hands I commit my spirit. And having said thus, he gave up the ghost. Oh, let me tell you something. The devil may have thought he might have won the battle when he died on Calvary's Hill. But let me tell you, through searching through the Word of God, those 3 days and those 3 nights that he was dead, let me tell you, he went back to heaven. Glory be to God that he went back and preached unto the souls of men that was in captive and set the captives free. Glory be to God, and walked into hell itself and got the keys of hell and of death. Amen. And the book of Revelation tells us that. Glory be to God. Let me tell you something. Jesus has won that battle for us. Jesus has won that war for us. Glory be to God. He didn't stay in the grave. He didn't stay dead for no reason. Glory be to God. But let me tell you, he stayed dead for that for reason that we can have life and have it more abundantly. I want you to listen. And upon the first day of the week, very early in the morning, they came unto the sepulcher, bringing the spices which they had prepared, and certain others with them. And they found the stone rolled away from the sepulcher. Glory be to God. And they entered in and found not the body of the Lord Jesus. And it came to pass, as they were much perplexed thereabout, behold, two men stood by them in shining garments. And as they were afraid, and bowed down their faces to earth, and they said unto him, Why ye seek the living among the dead? Amen. Let me tell you, Jesus gave us that victory. Jesus fought that victory for us. Glory be to God. We got battles to go through. Glory be to God. And the only way that we can win that battle is through the blood of Jesus Christ. The only way that we can win that battle is through prayer and taking it to the Lord. Amen. Glory be to God. Let me tell you, we're in a fight. We're in a battle. Let me tell you, some people out there is a playing church. Glory be to God. As my pastor says, they're tiptoeing through the tulips. Glory be to God. They're walking through a flower garden and playing church. But let me tell you, that ain't going to get it. We've got to live righteous. We've got to live holy. We've got to be set apart from this world. Church, let me tell you, we might lose a battle every now and then. We might get down and we might fall down on our knees every now and then. But church, a Christian, brother, a sister, don't stay down on the ground, but get up and dust your pants off, get forgiveness, and walk towards the gold. Because, let me tell you, the war was already won on Calvary's Hill. Amen. Glory be to God. Oh, I thought, you know, man might judge you. Man might judge you going to hell because you made a mistake. But I want you to notice in the book of 1 John, oh, let me tell you, I got to bring that out. In the book of 1 John, he said in 1 John chapter 2, My little children, these things write unto you, that ye sin not. And if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous. And he is the propitiation for our sins, and not for ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world. Oh, wow. Are you understanding what I'm saying. Now, let me tell you, when we get saved, he saves us from our sins. He don't save us in our sins. Amen. Glory be to God. Let me tell you something. Jesus is the author and the finisher of our faith. Amen. Oh, let me tell you, he's the beginning and the end. He's the first and the last. Oh, he's our soon coming King. Glory be to God. And let me tell you, beyond a shadow of a doubt, that victory was already won on Calvary's hill. That victory was won on the morning that he rose from the grave, victorious over death, hell, and the grave. Amen. I could preach on and on. But tell you, there's many battles to be fought, but the war's already won. Amen. Let's go to prayer. Gracious Heavenly Father, the greatest battle that a person will fight in their life, glory be to God, is stepping out and accepting the Lord Jesus Christ as their Savior. Accepting you as the Savior of the world. That's the greatest battle that they're going to ever fight in their life. And Lord, I pray that they will make that right decision, because right now, Lord, that sinner, that backslider is serving the lost cause, because they're on the wrong side. But as the song says, Lord Jesus, come on over to the winning side. Amen. Glory be to God. Lord, I pray that someone will convict their soul, Lord, that they will bow down and confess you at their Lord. Glory be to God. Amen and amen. Now at the same time, I ask, Lord God, that you will heal the sick. Lord, whatever the problem may be, headaches, stomach problems, glory be to God, poison ivy, whatever the problem may be, a wasp sting, whatever the problem may be, I ask that you will heal right now, Lord God. Oh, Lord God. Father, I praise your holy name. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. If you like what you hear, let me know. Push that like button. Amen. Glory be to God. We're back on, and we're glad to be back. We ask that you will just push that like button. Let me know something. Look us up on the web, http://gospeltimeministries.weebly.com. Amen. Glory be to God. Jesus is coming soon. Are you ready? Until next time, God bless you.